We have a lady here speaking, and we have a group of individuals who don't want her to speak.
What do you mean about her being sued?
Sorry, sir, let me get
it.
Because I do not know.
Islam, because of the teachings of Islam, our brothers and sisters in majority countries are persecuted. Because of the teachings of Islam, we do have children in this country being used as a prostitute. Because of the teachings of Islam. Police turned blind eye, government turned blind eye, Muslim took the opportunity, not all of them, certain people group took opportunity and used those white British girls as a prostitute. Not acceptable. Child marriage, not acceptable. Islam practice it, tells people to do it, their prophet did it.
White Christian men also do it as well, you know that, don't they?
Sorry?
White Christian men also do it. Powerful white Christian men.
People do lots of crazy things. I am talking about what your scripture tells you to do. Scripture of Islam, Quran, tells people to divorce a child. What do you need to do to divorce a child? Why do you need to divorce a child? When do you divorce a child? You have sex with a child, then you divorce a child.
Not acceptable.
People who abuse a child, people who go against the Christian scripture, need to repent. They need to turn to Lord Jesus Christ. They need to repent and they need to get. They need to deal with the punishment of their crime. But ideologies out there simply encouraging. People can justify their action simply picking up a book and saying, this is what the book says, I am being faithful. Yeah. So Islam, in that case, you are not agreeing with Islam. Then you should stand up and then say, Islam is false ideology and dangerous ideology. Because this is the simply basic teachings of Islam.
I'm already standing up against the government and the powers of this country to incarcerate a free, a journalist, an award-winning journalist called Julian Assange.
No, that's what I do.
She's telling me. Yeah, no, I know, but what I'm saying is, she's telling me to stand up and talk out against Muslims.
No. I didn't say stand up and talk against Muslims.
Islam.
About the ideology. Ideology is dangerous. Muslims are made in God's image. My God gave Himself for them. Ideology is the one which is dangerous.
I'll tell you what's more dangerous. Boris Johnson in power at the moment.
What? Well,
good. More dangerous.
Good,
more dangerous.
You are practicing your freedom of speech and saying that. That's very good.
America are basically imprisoning an award-winning journalist in Julian Assange because he told the truth.
I am very
that
grateful.
That is very dangerous.
And they're also bringing
in a bill.
Sir, what is your name?
LEO Inspector.
Okay, I'll just call you sir.
LEO Inspector.
Let me say something. It is very great that today you are publicly criticizing the Prime Minister of England.
I've been doing this for 12 years.
Yeah, so you are doing this 12 years. Can you tell me how many times people wanted to chop your head off?
They imprisoned
me. How many times?
Hold on, let me finish.
Because you critiqued Boris Johnson,
I've been
people wanted to chop your head
off. I've been imprisoned, I've been arrested, I've been assaulted, and I've had threats to kill me because of what I do.
See how dangerous it is. The moment you criticize ideologies, the moment you criticize people, people want to come after you. Not acceptable. Yes, sir.
Could I ask you, do you have a message for the person who did hurt you the other week?
He needs to turn to Lord Jesus Christ. When someone doesn't have peace with God, they will never have peace with one another. Islamic God doesn't offer anyone peace. It is only God of Christian scripture, who is Father, and who is loving his son before the foundation of the world in the fellowship of Holy Spirit. Only that God is going to offer people peace. Why? Because his son gave his life on the cross for us to have peace with God and us to have peace with one another. Without peace, nothing will change. Whoever that person is needs to turn to Lord Jesus Christ. I can't do anything.
Thank you ever so much.
That's okay, sir.
God bless you.
I am okay, sir. Yeah, today's new day. I'm okay.
Shake your hand.
You don't need to shake my hand, sir. I am a simple person.
We all. Expect to go.
Sir, you've got lots of things.
Sorry.
Hey, you take care now.
I'm fine. I'm fine. You don't need to worry about it. I'm fine. I'm the last person you need to worry about, okay? Okay, can I get on with the line? Ah,
sorry,
I forgot to tell you. Islam is not only my problems with Islam, you were asking, since my list hasn't finished. I've got lots of this. Islam also encourages slavery.
Yeah. And
people in Islam, you've got eternal slaves in Islamic paradise. Not only today's world, Islam is not only all slavery and colorism, but there is also eternal slaves in Islamic paradise. So, not acceptable in 21st century.
Yeah.
Okay, so we can get on.
Why would you say that Christianity is much better? What are the positives of Christianity?
I don't say Christianity is better. I say Christianity is the only way. There is only one way, and that's Lord Jesus Christ. I'm very serious about it because look at the world. We are in our depths. Who bothered to do something about anyone? No one. It is only Lord Jesus Christ, eternal Son of living God, stepped in and did something for us. He showed his care, he showed his concern, he gave himself for us out of love, without any obligation. He is the only way. There is no any other way. It's not a better way, it is the only way. I know that is like so not acceptable in British culture, but according to my scripture, that is the only way.
Do you not believe that it's possible for people to be good people and live good, honest lives without being Christians?
Oh, none of us is good. Only God is good. Even my good deeds are as dirty rocks, Bible says. So, I don't think we can be good without God.
Do you believe that non-Christians can go to heaven?
I believe if someone, the way you can have eternal life is believing Jesus Christ is the Messiah and eternal Son of God. There is no any other way. So, in that case, short answer to your question is no. But I do have lovely friends. That doesn't mean my lovely friends who do not accept Lord Jesus Christ is going to spend eternity with him. Because if you don't want Lord Jesus Christ, and then if he tells you, come to heaven with me, be with me, that heaven will be hell for you. You don't want him. I want him. She wants him. Do you want him? No. She doesn't want him. If God takes him to heaven, that heaven will be hell for her because she doesn't want him. You don't want to go to hell.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Okay, I need to get on with my life now. I've got life, you know.
Do you have an umbrella, Hatton?
Sorry?
Umbrella.
I don't need umbrella.
Sure.
I don't need umbrella. And I noticed you didn't worry about me. You don't need to worry about me. I'm fine, okay? If I'm causing you to get upset or
sick, I'm not upset.
Okay, because people say you are very upset.
Hello.
Okay, we moved on.
Jesus said in the Quran, anybody who don't believe I am a king, bring him to me and slaughter him. Jesus said.
Wow, you are such a liar. Bless you. Bless your heart.
Bless your heart.
After bless your heart, repent and turn to Lord Jesus.
I am son of God.
Repent.
Hallelujah.
Repent.
I am Messiah.
You had a skull cap on.
God wipe my feet. I am Messiah. God wipe my feet. God wipe my feet. I am Messiah. Hallelujah. I am son of God.
People can believe
I am son of God.
Lord Jesus Christ.
Allah Akbar. I am son of God. I am son of God. I am Messiah. Hallelujah. I am son of God. I am Messiah. God wipe my feet. God wipe my feet.
I'll ask you to repent. There is no any other way for you.
I am Messiah.
You've got to repent.
God wiped my feet.
You've got to repent.
God did not wipe Jesus' feet.
You've got to repent.
God did not wipe Jesus' feet. God wiped my feet. I am the Messiah. I will prepare a new world for Jesus.
Why Peter?
This world will be destroyed in World War III in Iraq. And I will prepare a new world for Jesus. God met me yesterday in disguise.
I'll ask you again. Repent. 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 There is no any other way for you. You are actively and intentionally blaspheming. I'll ask you to repent.
God meet me. God does not meet you. Because I am
your
the Messiah.
God meets you. My God meets me. Your God is so needy.
God meets me.
Jesus,
I am the Messiah. I am the Messiah. Hallelujah.
Your God is very much needy.
I am Son of God. I am Messiah. I will prepare new world for Jesus.
You didn't die from my sin.
I will prepare new world for Jesus. Look.
You're a sinner.
Look.
No,
look.
Thank you.
The sign.
Oh, it's a sign from you?
From God. God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Don't you have the privilege you have? You cannot speak his corner. Blaspheme Lord Jesus Christ.
And he didn't speak
his corner.
Nobody
blasphemes Lord Jesus Christ. No one is chopping his head off.
I'm of God.
Run away. When you heard the magic word of Allah Akbar, what you do? You need to run away.
Hallelujah!
You need to run away.
I am Son of God. I am Messiah. I am Messiah. God, wipe my feet. I am the Messiah.
Repent. Repent and turn to Lord Jesus Christ.
I will prepare a new world for Jesus. I will prepare new world. This bullshit, bullshit. This world will be destroyed.
Yeah, will.
In a nuclear holocaust. I will prepare new world for Jesus. America and Russia will go into Iraq. Computers will push nuclear button in 1 second.
Let me tell you something.
World will be destroyed.
Let me tell you something very important.
25 minutes.
Can I tell you something?
World will be destroyed.
Control yourself. I'm going to tell you something very important.
You cannot control yourself. You mock the Quran. You make hole in the Quran.
Yeah, there are holes in
you
the Quran.
You are a sinner.
I am sinner and I need a savior.
I
will be with Lord
Jesus Christ. You are enemy of God. You are enemy of God.
I am enemy of Allah.
You are enemy of God.
You do not think the 39 different Qurans, Michael.
Hallelujah! I am Son of God. I am Son of God. I am Son of God. Allah Akbar. I am the Messiah.
Allah Alaskar.
Don't mock the Quran.
Why?
It's God's book.
You just mock my God and you are telling me to do not mock the Quran. Let me tell you something. King of kings, Lord of lords, Lord Jesus Christ humbled himself, stepped into this world so that Islam destroys. Stepped into this world so that people can know God and do not run behind the false gods. You are running behind the false gods and you are blaspheming
Jesus
against
the 3-year-old
God.
Moses
married
3-year-old girl. God wipe my feet. I am the Messiah. I will prepare new world for second coming of Jesus. I will prepare new world for Jesus.
All right.
This world will be destroyed in a nuclear holocaust.
Really?
It's gonna happen.
Really?
In 1 second.
Really?
In 25 minutes. World will be destroyed.
Right.
America and Russia got
so
back on
so
to kill everybody 341 times. I am persuading America and Russia not to go into Iraq.
Are you Allah? Can I see your shin?
Can I see your shin?
I need to go back and identify Allah as my
Let me just point out something. in case anyone missed it.
No,
a person can simply blaspheme against my God and speak his Quran, and it is okay. It is okay. No one wants to chop his head off. But same person who blasphemes against my God also tells me, do not put the holes in the Quran. See?
Whatever.
I read the Bible.
They can practice their freedom of speech, but when it comes to my freedom of speech, Speaker's Corner becomes Pakistan. Speaker's Corner becomes Saudi Arabia. Not acceptable. Not acceptable.
Yes.
Yes, it is correct that King of Kings, eternal Son of God, stepped in and become a servant. He humbled himself. While he became a servant, he sat down and washed the Allahu al-Askar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu al-Askar.
Allahu
al-Askar. He washed the feet of his disciples.
It's fine, brother. Thank you.
Yeah,
it's
fine.
That's
good.
The rapist. No concern.
Wait,
so,
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Do your religion tell you to be disrespectful? Allahu Akbar!
Yeah, it's Allahu Akbar!
Your religion does!
Allahu Akbar!
Your religion does!
And it's the Quran!
Allahu
Akbar!
Since your God is so big, can you be kind enough and tell me about the whole simple narrative? Allahu al-Askar!
Allahu
al-Askar! Allahu al-Askar! Allahu al-Askar! Allahu al-Askar! Allahu al-Askar!
Allahu
al-Askar!
Allahu
al-Askar!
Allahu
al-Askar!
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu
Akbar!
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu
Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
Allah
is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is bigger. Allah is big Amen. So, holes in the Quran. Quran, holes in the narrative, holes in Muhammad, pictures of Muhammad, all Blackstone, all those kind of things is not going to help you. It is only you're healed, you're fixed, and you put together only and because of the blood of Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
There is no any other way. No other way. I am very serious. I am very serious. When scripture says there is no any other way, scripture is not joking about it. There is seriously no any other way. If there was any other way, eternal Son of living God wouldn't step in and give himself on the cross for us.
Yeah, he praises him. Yeah.
There was no any other way. Therefore, he stepped in and gave himself for us.
Yeah, he's my king. He's our king. Yeah.
His servant king, king of kings,
king of
becomes
kings.
A servant.
Is he excited, boy?
Why? People like me, people like him. I really don't know what is all about him, but eternal Son of God loves him enough to give himself for him.
I love him so much. Thank because you, Jesus, you. For giving your life so that I can live.
There is nothing attractive with him, but he still gave his life for him. There is nothing attractive in me and with me, but eternal Son of God gave himself for me. I don't know why, but I know he loved me enough to do so.
Yes,
so, saying Allahu Akbar, Allah is a little bit bigger, is not going to help you. Come up with proper rebuttals. Come up with proper answer and fix the holes in the narrative. Only way hole is going to be fixed is when you turn to the one who has holes in his hand and who has holes in his feet. Grow up, people. Seriously, times are coming. People are dying. Every day someone is dying and they do not know they are forgiven by the blood of Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Can you see how depressing it is?
Amen.
The world is very much depressing. People are dying with not knowing they are forgiven by the blood of Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
21st century, we live in a society where there is internet, where there are human beings, but also there are people who do not know they are forgiven. That is heartbreaking. They are dying not knowing they are forgiven.
Yeah.
So, best way to move forward, and best way and only way to move forward is you need to find the ways to get to the God. You know what? We cannot find that way. We cannot by ourselves, we cannot turn to God. What God does is, he sends his son meets with us where we are. Not his son kind of says, oh guys, by the way, turn left, turn right. His son comes and meets us in the spot where we are. Gave himself for us. Gave his life, died on the cross. Even grave couldn't hold the King of Kings.
Amen.
He conquered the grave.
Amen.
Can you imagine? Grave couldn't hold the eternal Son of living God.
He defeated death.
Amen.
Death
he has
is being defeated.
Death.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes. Therefore, you turn to him.
Yes.
He meets with you where you are.
Yes.
He says, be mine.
Yes.
If we are not his, it is very common that we will see that we will be chopping people's head off.
Yep.
But once you are with him, once you are in him, once you are his, life is different.
Mm-hmm.
Because you will know what is peace. You will know what is life in its fullness. Why? Because eternal Son of the living God, Lord Jesus Christ, give that to you.
Yes,
you experience it, you know it, and you live for it. He is worthy. He is worthy, people.
Yeah, he's worthy, because I'm not worthy. I'm unworthy, but Jesus is worthy.
I am sorry to tell you, brother, but you are nothing. You are nobody. Yet, Lord Jesus Christ identifies you his friend. He identifies people like you and like me as his friend, and he chooses you out of billions to say be mine. So that's the difference.
And that's the best thing to ever happen to me in my whole life.
Yeah. Nothing can even match with that.
No, nothing can match with that. No, not at all.
I'm going to get on with my life, people. I don't know why you are here, but I am here. funny. I am now. Because last week I become more convinced that he will meet glorious gospel. So he will meet glorious gospel.
Preach in season and out of season.